The AIADMK under Sasikala claimed that 131 out of its 134 MLAs attended the meeting chaired by Sasikala to discuss the fallout of the revolt by caretaker Chief Minister O. Paneerselvam. They claim the party cadres are with them. Meanwhile, scores of AIADMK supporters from across the state have also been thronging the Chief Minister Paneerselvam's residence to express solidarity with him. And they raised slogans hailing Amma and vowed that they will never call anyone Chinnamma.
The AIADMK in Tamil Nadu is facing a power struggle of epic proportions between the newly elected leader of the legislature party and interim general secretary Sasikala and incumbent O. Paneerselvam. He recently resigned and now is a caretaker chief minister. Both sides are trying their level best to get the support of 134 AIADMK MLAs. All eyes are on the governor Vidyasagar Rao now, who is weighing his options. On Tuesday night, Paneerselvam spent hours meditating at the tomb of late Chief Minister Jayalalitha, whose death has caused a leadership vacuum in the ruling party. After his meditation, Paneerselvam came out in open revolt against Sasikala. He told the media that he had been forced to resign and if the people wanted, he could withdraw his resignation. He also claims to have adequate support of MLAs to win a floor test. Paneerselvam says he will order a probe into Jayalalitha's death, indirectly pointing at Sasikala's role. Paneerselvam alleges that he was not allowed to meet Jayalalitha in Apollo Hospital.
People have grave doubts about Amma's demise. Government has the responsibility to clear them. I have requested for a probe under a sitting Supreme Court judge to investigate the issue.
After his open revolt, Sasikala called an emergency meeting at Jayalalitha's residence and she also claims that the party is intact and she has full support of party legislators. She even dismissed Paneerselvam's allegations. Sasikala has accused Paneerselvam of betraying Amma and working with the opposition DMK to destabilize the AIADMK. Claiming to hold on to Amma's ideals, she said she would protect the party's image and continue to follow late CM's footsteps. Meanwhile, the opposition DMK has denied any role in the internal power struggle of the ruling party.
DMK has no need to get involved into their inner party politics.
Sasikala has removed Paneerselvam from the post of treasurer as well. An associate of Paneerselvam was also removed as the head of the party's IT cell.
Right now I've been removed from the party position and because I was showing support to Honorable O. Paneerselvam. I congratulate and for the new secretary who has got the appointment. I would like to work continuously and show my commitment and dedication in the path Amma has shown and I will extend my support to O. Paneerselvam and I'll work for the vision that Amma has shown.
All eyes are now on the governor who is still in Maharashtra where he holds dual charge. He is reportedly exploring all legal options. His decision is likely to be influenced by the Supreme Court's decision, which is likely to come within a week in a disproportionate assets case involving late Jayalalitha and co-accused Sasikala. The central government has also left it on the governor.
The governor is the constitutional authority. He is examining all aspects according to the media reports. He will take an appropriate decision as per the constitution, as per the legal advice, as per the procedure, as per the precedents earlier. And there is no reason to criticize anybody in this regard.
Sasikala was made the new general secretary of the AIADMK after Jayalalitha's death, but the election commission has raised questions about the manner of his election after reading the party rules. It has asked the party whether proper procedure was followed or not in her appointment. There has been no response from the party as yet. There is also a PIL pending in the Supreme Court which seeks to restrain Sasikala from becoming Chief Minister. Amid the fast-paced political development, Sasikala Natarajan is doing her best to wrest power of both party and state, but the crown which sits uneasily on Paneerselvam's head is not hers as yet. And he, despite his resignation, still sits on the chair. Caretaker or real? That's the big question.
Right now, Sasikala does not want to leave this golden opportunity and she is still working out her strategy and she says that if the governor delays the procedure, she will approach the President of India also and try to see that the government is installed here in Tamil Nadu without much delay. With Philip Matthews, Aisha Khanam, DD News, Chennai.